Hello, welcome to my channel. In the magnetic effect of current topic, in that continuation today we will discuss the galvanometer, a device which measures the which detects the presence of current in a circuit. Types of galvanometer: there are two types of galvanometer, moving coil galvanometer and suspended coil galvanometer. On which principle it's based and what is the working of the galvanometer, what is the construction, today we discuss all these things. Before proceeding further, I would like to say please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for further notification. The galvanometer, a device to detect the presence of current in a circuit, and the principle, its principle is based on the torque which we have discussed earlier. I will give the link along with the description of this video. You can see the description of the torque. What is the principle of galvanometer? Whenever the current carrying coil is placed in magnetic field, it experiences a torque due to which the coil is deflected, and the amount of torque depends on the strength of current flowing through it. This is asked, what is the principle of galvanometer? So you have to say only these two lines, that whenever the current carrying coil is placed in magnetic field, it is deflected and deflecting torque is produced. That torque, its magnitude of torque depends on the current flowing through it. Now look, what are the galvanometers, which two types? In the figure I have shown, I will explain new construction first. Then along with the principle and working, I will explain. Look here, this is the suspended coil galvanometer, its figure I have shown here. A coil is wound on an aluminium frame. This is the aluminium frame at which the coil, copper coil, is wound. Its one end is connected with the loosely wound spring and through the connecting screw T2. Other end here connected with the mirror, and this total coil is suspended by a long thin phosphor bronze strip. This is a thin strip, and its upper end is connected with the torsion head and this end with the screw T1. So this long strip of phosphor bronze through which at its lower end mirror is connected, plane mirror, and here the copper coil. So this is the copper coil. The soft iron core through which this frame or this copper coil, they are not in contact, this is placed in the middle, and soft iron core is useful to having high strong magnetic field lines present. These are the two poles of magnet, powerful magnet. They produce a strong magnetic field. Why the phosphor bronze strip is taken? Because through it the coil is suspended. Its thin strip through which the large number of turns in the coil, it is suspended, so its high tensile strength. Its less torsional constant, C is torsional constant. Why less? Because current sensitivity of the galvanometer will become more, you will see later on. And it is rust proof, it is good conductor, it also has less elastic after effect. These are the properties, these are also asked in the examination. Another type of galvanometer, this is called pivoted galvanometer. These are the two pivots. Same thing here, soft iron core, aluminium frame at which the copper coil is wound. One end of the copper coil is attached with the spring, and a spring is pivoted here. Similarly, the other end. And these are the screws through which we make the connection. And here at the frame, a light pointer is also connected, which can read the which can move on the linear scale, and in the galvanometer zero remains in the middle, so that there is no positive negative signs, because from zero the pointer can go through the left side or through the right side. It depends on left or right side depending on the direction of current presence in the circuit. So as per the presence of current, this pointer can move. Now what happens? We have seen that whenever its principle, I have discussed that whenever a current carrying coil is placed in the magnetic field, in both the figures, coil is placed in the magnetic field, a deflecting torque is produced, and that torque is given by the relation. I will write the relation, then I will show you. This torque is given by torque equal to N I A B sine theta. You know, symbols have usual meaning. N number of turns, I current in the coil, A area vector at the plane of the coil, and B magnetic field. What is theta? Theta is the angle between area vector and magnetic field. So what happens? Suppose this is the magnetic field. Initially I have designed this with the help of, suppose these are the north and south poles of a magnet, these are the magnetic field lines, and these are the magnetic field lines. Pointed head, it is showing that these are the originating lines are originating from the north pole, and this from the south pole, towards the south pole. What happens? Suppose this is the soft iron coil, this is the aluminium frame, and this is the area vector, and here it is attached with the spring. You can say also that it is suspended. So what happens whenever the current flow through the coil? So suppose if you say that in this position of the coil, what will happen? Maximum torque position, because area vector and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other. So sine theta, sine 90 will become 1. In this position, what will happen? Zero torque. Why zero? Because area vector and magnetic field both are parallel. Theta is 0, sine 0, 0. So whenever the current flow through the coil, then it rotates. Due to its rotation, the spring attached here and at the lower end also, what happens that the twist is produced in the spring. Due to the twist produced in the spring, what happens that whenever it is deflected, then due to twist it tries to regain its original position. So suppose the due to the rotation, suppose I have given the rotation here like this, then it will rotate in this way. Why it comes back? Because of the twist in the phosphor bronze strip and spring, or in the spring in the pivoted type. So what happens that whenever deflecting torque is produced, this torque is called deflecting torque, then it is counterbalanced by the restoring torque produced in the spring. This restoring torque produced by the spring or strip, whenever these two torques become same, since they are their nature is opposite, the coil comes at rest, and this is called equilibrium position. So in the equilibrium position, the deflecting torque and restoring torque become equal. Now what is the restoring torque? This restoring torque is given by the formula C phi, where C is the torsional constant, and you can define C as C equal to this restoring torque upon phi. Torsional constant definition is also asked. टॉर्सनल कांस्टेंट इज डिफाइंड एज रिस्टोरिंग टॉर्क पर यूनिट ट्विस्ट. व्हाट इज फाई? फाई इज द एंगल इन द ट्विस्ट इन द स्प्रिंग, एंगल ऑफ ट्विस्ट. सो व्हाट हैपन दैट व्हेन एवर this NIAB sin theta, that is deflecting torque and restoring torque, becomes same, then you can write here that this I can be written as C upon NAB phi upon sin theta. Now look what happens. Galvanometer, the pointer is to move at the linear scale. What should be for that? Phi and I both should be directly proportional. And what we have seen here, that C upon NAB is constant, but I is proportional to, you can write here that this implies that I is proportional to phi upon sin theta. We have to, if anyhow we remove this sin theta dependence, then what will you find? That I will be proportional to phi. Now here is the need of radial magnetic field. Not like this. Here the magnetic field is uniform, but it is all the lines of force are parallel and equidistant. Why this will not work? Because in every position of the coil, the torque will be different. Because theta will be different. Here theta 90, here some angle, some less angle, here it is 0. So theta dependence will remain if you take the magnetic field like this. So what is done? Instead of this magnetic field, a radial magnetic field is selected. I have shown here that this is the north pole of a concave cut powerful magnet, and this is the south pole of the concave cut magnet. I have shown with the help of these toothpicks. So look here, suppose this is the soft iron core, and at which this is the coil. This is the pointer, aluminium pointer, as I have shown here. This is the pointer, and these are the forces. So if we see the top view of this figure, so what will you observe? Like this I have shown in the figure, and I will show in this demonstration. Is it visible? That top view, at the top view you will find this spring, these are the coil, this number of turns, copper coil. So I have shown here these coil, this is the pointer, and this will be the soft iron core, its top view. So this is the soft iron core, and top view will be like this. So whenever the current will flow through the coil, what will happen? Look here that in this position, these are the two equal and opposite forces. They will produce the torque. Now, in every position of the coil, what will you find? That its plane will be always parallel to the magnetic field. So, this pointer will rotate like this. Pointer will move on the linear scale, and the soft iron core, look, its front, this one, this is the top view. That for every position of the coil, the torque will remain maximum. The plane of the coil will remain parallel to the magnetic field. How this happened? Due to the presence, we have taken the concave cut magnet and this concave cut cylindrical soft iron. Concave cut magnet and cylindrical soft iron piece. Both of these make the field radial, and due to radial magnetic field and presence of soft iron core, distribution of the field lines you know, they are approaching towards center and they are leaving the center towards the south pole. Concentration becomes maximum due to presence of soft iron core. Why? Because its permeability is high, and in the strong magnetic field whose pattern is radial, we find that for every position of the coil, the torque remains maximum, or the plane of the coil remains parallel to the magnetic field. So what can you say here? That in this case, finally, this sin theta in the radial magnetic field sin theta becomes 1, since theta becomes 90 for every position of the coil. Now what happens? We get the relation I proportional to phi. So in this way, the pointer can move on the linear scale and we can find the direction of current. Now both the suspended coil and pivoted type galvanometer, both are said to be moving coil galvanometer. Here the coil is suspended through the phosphor bronze strip. Here the coil is pivoted. But there is a difference also, that in this galvanometer we take the observation through lamp and scale arrangement, and its size is very big. It can't be displaced from one position to other, but it has a quality that its sensitivity is more. It can measure up to the 10 to the power minus 9 ampere current. So its sensitivity is more. What about pivoted type galvanometer? It is portable. You can displace it, and also in this coil, in this galvanometer, it is convenient to use, but its sensitivity is less as compared to suspended coil galvanometer. It can measure up to 10 to the power minus 6 ampere current of this order. So in this way, I described you that what is moving coil galvanometer, these two types of galvanometer, their construction, on what principle it works, what is the need of radial magnetic field, and why the phosphor bronze strip is used. Some more questions are asked, that what is current sensitivity, what is voltage sensitivity, why do we use galvanometer to detect the to make the ammeter and voltmeter. We will discuss in the next section. And look, in this way you can describe the total working and need of radial magnetic field for a galvanometer. This is very important question. I hope you must have understood the all things regarding moving coil galvanometer. Thank you.